Hi, I'm Jacob Farron with Sarasania Northwest, and welcome to Ask the Carnivorous Plant Guys. This is where we answer your questions to help you grow better carnivorous plants. We have a question in from Matt, and he writes, I read that the soil for all carnivorous plants needs to be replaced once every year. I have many Drosera adelae multiplying and growing in one large pot. Since you guys specialize in cultivating carnivorous plants, I'm wondering if there's an easier way to transplant sundews. I tried transplanting one sundew and it was a total mess. The soil got over the dews. There's about 20 to 30 more in the pot. I can't imagine the mess. Well, Matt, welcome to our world. Repotting Drosera adelae, also known as the lance leaf sundew, can sometimes be very messy. The leaves are very sticky, so it's very easy to get soil all over the sundew. But I'm going to show you a technique to at least minimize the mess. This particular plant has been growing in this pot for well over a year, and it's definitely crowded out here and could use a repotting. This other plant has been in this pot for less than a year, but it's not growing very well. The soil might be very funky. I'm not sure why it's not growing well. So I'm just going to repot it to freshen it up and see if that does the job. Now, before beginning this process, what you'll need are the following. You'll need a towel, and the towel is important to wipe your hands if you get any soil on your hands. A pair of scissors to trim off dead leaves. A spoon. Tweezers, and this one's really important. A bowl of water, and your pots of soil ready to go. I've even created holes in the pot so that way I don't have to get my hands dirty once I'm handling the sundews. And the soil mix I'm using is one part peat moss and one part perlite, the standard soil mix I use for tropical sundews. When repotting Drosera adelae, you have to be patient. You have to be slow and deliberate in your actions. If you rush the process, you're likely to get soil all over the sundew. Now let's start. We'll get everything in place. And the first thing we're gonna do is trim off all of the dead leaves here. And you wanna do that now, rather than waiting till later, because it's gonna be a lot easier to keep this plant clean. All right, now this part, you're gonna have to be very careful because you're gonna have to remove the plant from the pot and place the pot to the side like this and gently tug on it. You don't want it upside down because that's gonna get the soil all over the plant. So just keep it to the side and squeeze the pot to loosen up the soil, and there we go. Now I lucked out on this one. This plant is definitely root bound. You can see the roots just like intertwined here and went around the pot and kept the soil in place. So I'm pretty lucky in that part. But what I'm gonna do is get my tweezers, and I'm just gonna hold the top part of this plant here, and that's going to minimize the contact with the soil, and dunk it into the water here. And I'm going to use my other hand to loosen up some of this old soil. And again, be very patient with this process. Don't try to rush it. And this is what the plant looks like once it's unpotted. The roots are white and supple, exactly what you want. And you get a few plantlets coming off, and just place these the plantlets to the side. Now, if you want to divide this up, it's very easy to do. Just keep your, be very gentle and tug at it, holding the sides of the sundew, and just give it a gentle tug, and there you go. Now you have two clumps of sundew. Now I'm not going to even try to transplant every single sundew here because this plant it's not necessary to do that. They reproduce by runners, and it's a lot easier to keep the plant clean of soil by keeping them as clumps. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to place this one down right there on the table, and already have my pot ready to go. And this is where I use my spoon to guide the roots into the soil, just like this. And of course, if you get any soil on your hands, definitely wipe them off before you start touching your sundew. And there's a plant down there in the soil. I'm going to let that one go. It's not worth trying to salvage, but just going to push all of that root mass into the hole that I already created and firmly place it in there. And then using the back of the spoon, again, tapping down the soil to secure the plant in place. And wipe down the pot. And we're going to repot the other clump. And we got a piece of root out here. You know, I'm just going to pull that off. And again, this plant is very, very tough. It will come back even if you break the roots a bit. It's a very easy plant to grow, and that's why it's a great plant for beginners. And here you go. From one pot of plant, now you have two. And before I take out this plant, I'm going to cut off the dead leaves here. Okay. Now this plant isn't as large, it doesn't have as many clumps. In fact, I only see about 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 plantlets in here. So it's going to be a bit more difficult to transplant because the soil isn't going to be bound up by the roots like the other plant. Now in this case, I'm going to use the back end of the spoon to loosen up the soil around it, around the plant, before I even try to take it out of the pot. And just be careful not to get any of the soil on the leaves. Take your time. And sometimes I'll reach in towards the bottom and push the plant up slightly. Yeah, you might hit a few roots. It's okay. The plant will come back. Okay. Now I feel it there. I'm going to take my tweezers and I'm going to open it up wide and try to grab around the mass of the plant as much as I can. And I'm going to tilt it sideways to let the plant fall out of the pot as I'm squeezing the pot. And there we go. It's coming out. All right. And I'm just going to remove some of the soil around here. Yeah, it's going to create a big mess, but at least the mess is on the table and not on the plant. Once you got the mess there, take it into the water and just dunk it there. Get the soil, the old soil out. All right. Now that it's all cleaned up, we're going to place it into the hole, just like so. There's a plantlet there. I'm gonna let that one go. Don't worry about it. The main plant itself, the clump, is gonna survive. And use your spoon to help you get all the roots into the soil. And now I'm gonna pat it down. Occasionally wipe off the spoon of any soil so that way it doesn't get on the leaves, and just tap it down, secure the plant in place, and there you go. That's how you transplant Drosera adelae, and keeping the mess on the table and not on your plants. If you need help growing carnivorous plants, send us your question. Go to cobraplant.com and click on the Ask the Experts link. That will redirect you to our webpage on allexperts.com. And then click on Ask a Question link. And on the question page, provide as much information as possible about your plant and your growing conditions. And who knows, maybe we'll use your question on a future episode of Ask the Carnivorous Plant Guys. Thank you for watching and good growing.